The initial expansion of transportation networks for mass production industries was also water-based. In industrializing countries, canal building became a craze from the 1810s through the 1840s. Many local canals connected newly established towns and villages in the interior to markets all over the United States and Great Britain and continental Europe. The Erie Canal in New York, for example, connected Buffalo, New York, on Lake Erie to Albany, where the canal met the Hudson River, which was then navigable all the way to New York City. Over 350 miles long when it was completed in 1825, the Erie Canal included 36 locks to ease the barges down a gradual decline of more than 550 feet from Lake Erie in Buffalo to the Hudson River near Albany. As agricultural goods were shipped down the canal and eventually made their way to markets in industrial East Coast cities or even in England or Europe, farmers established new farms all along the canal, and the Erie Canal was the key to Western settlement and expansion of the United States, especially before 1865. Canal workers were frequently Irish immigrants who often settled nearby once the canal was built. Steam power soon became extremely important in transportation as well. Until steam engines were put on riverboats, shipping had depended on either wind or on river currents, or on human and animal power on canal towpaths. Goods could easily be floated south on rivers from farms in the American interior, for example, but it was much more difficult and expensive to ship products against the currents up to the frontier. Flatboats and rafts accumulated at downstream ports, such as New Orleans, and were often just broken down and burned as firewood. Steam engines made it possible to sail upstream as easily and as quickly as down, which caused an explosion of both travel and shipping that radically changed frontier life. Ocean-going steamships then made travel and shipping quicker and safer across the Atlantic and then the Pacific and allowed travelers and merchants to keep to regular schedules. Steam engines were a product of early European industrialism. The first steam patent was granted to a Spanish inventor named Jeronimo Beaumont in 1606. His engine drove a pump that was used to drain mines. The French scientist Papin built his steam engine in 1630 after visiting the Royal Society in London. And Englishman James Watt's 1781 engine was the first to produce rotary power that could be adapted to drive mills or wheels or propellers. Robert Fulton, an American inventor who had previously patented a canal dredging machine, visited Paris and caught steam fever. Fulton sailed an experimental steamboat on the Seine and then returned home and launched the first commercial American steamboat on the Hudson River in 1807. The Clermont was able to sail upriver 150 miles from New York City to Albany in 32 hours. In 1811, Fulton built the New Orleans in Pittsburgh and began regular steamboat service down the Ohio River to the Mississippi and ultimately to New Orleans. The other transportation technology enabled by steam power, of course, was the railroad, which was even more revolutionary than the steamboat. In spite of their power and their speed, steam-powered riverboats depended on rivers and occasionally on canals to run, but a railroad could be built almost anywhere. Suddenly, the expansion of commerce was no longer limited by the routes that nature had provided into the frontier. Small railroads using horses were already common in mining regions in Great Britain and Europe before the advent of steam power. The first railroads in the United States also were built on the East Coast before the steam engine was available to power them. Trains of cars pulled by horses looked a lot like stagecoaches on rails. But after Englishman George Stephenson's locomotives began pulling passengers and freight in northwestern England in the coal country in the mid-1820s, Americans quickly switched over to steam. The first locomotive used to pull cars in the United States was called Tom Thumb, and it was built in 1830 by Peter Cooper for the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad. Although Tom Thumb lost its maiden race against a horse-drawn train, the Baltimore and Ohio owners were convinced by the demonstration of steam technology, and they committed to developing steam locomotives. The B&O Railroad, which had been established in 1827 to compete with the Erie Canal, was already advertising itself as a faster way to move people and freight from the interior to the coast. Adding steam engines accelerated rail's advantage over canal and river shipping. So, some questions for discussion. First, why were canals and steam power so transformative? And then secondly, what was the major advantage of railroads over steamships?